So today we are actually going to get started in Psalm 1. And this, again, I have so many favorite passages of scriptures, but I love this psalm. And I must say that it's because it's my jams. Like, I relate to this psalm. I was never the popular kid growing up. I was never, you know, the one that was always invited to everything. I was never the cool kid. And it was because of the road that I chose to walk. I was a goody two-shoes. I was always in church. And you know what? It's okay. I learned to deal with that, and I learned that it was okay. I'm thankful for my parents and for their encouragement. And you know, that the Holy Spirit just said he was worth more. And looking back now, you know, 15, 20 years later, he was worth it. And so, the journey wasn't always easy, but the gain was always more than the cost. And that's what, you know, you and I have to decide in this journey of faith and in choosing to submit to the flesh or the spirit, is that, he is faithful. He is faithful. And, recompense and restoration, and he gives us back what we thought we lost, and he fills the voids that we thought we had, and things and people we didn't think we could live without. He is more than enough. And so that is a picture of Psalm 1. You know, I mentioned yesterday, we look at the blessed one, the one that the Bible calls blessed, and then the wicked or the ungodly. And those are the people who do not include God in their lives. And so today, what I really want to get into is just reading the scripture. I want this to get down in you, and I hope that you've got your Bibles, or you make your notes, or that you listen to this, and that you just receive the word of the Father. And of course, the word gives us direction. It gives us guidance. Lord, I thank you for understanding and revelation, that every time I read this passage, you reveal yourself to me more and more. There's another layer pulled back of who he is. And I thank you for that, Father. So I'm going to read this now, but I will tell you, this is another really exciting thing that I've got going on. So we have the Nancy Jo Ministries meeting. Our first meeting is January 26th at 10 o'clock in downtown Dunn, and it's called It's Go Time. And that, I believe, is where we are in the church, is it is go time. But at the meeting, I will have my first ministry book available, and it is on Psalm 1. And so I have put together, it's a 30-day devotional on Psalm 1, the material. We really get in depth to it, and I'm really excited about that. And so that will be available for purchase at the meeting in January. And so if you can't come to the meeting, you can still buy it through the website, or if you're local, you can get a hold of me and let me know. But I'll talk more about that as it gets here. But since we're starting Psalm 1, I will say that I've been working on that and I'm finishing up actually today and tomorrow, and we'll move forward with printing that. But I read, of course, out of the Amplified Classic Version. That's just my version, my study Bible of choice. And so whatever version you like to follow along in, but just so you know what I'm reading from, it's the Amplified Classic. Here we go with Psalm 1. Blessed, happy, fortunate, prosperous, and enviable is the man who walks and lives not in the counsel of the ungodly, following their advice, their plans and purposes, nor stands submissive and inactive in the path where sinners walk, nor sits down to relax and rest where the scornful and the mockers gather. But his delight and desire are in the law of the Lord, and on his law, the precepts, the instructions, the teachings of God, he habitually meditates, ponders and studies by day and by night. And he shall be like a tree, firmly planted and tended by the streams of water, ready to bring forth its fruit in its season. Its leaf also shall not fade or wither, and everything he does shall prosper, come to maturity. Not so the wicked. Those disobedient and living without God are not so. But they are like the chaff, worthless, dead, without substance, which the wind drives away. Therefore the wicked, Those disobedient and living without God shall not stand justified in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous, those who are upright and in right standing with God. For the Lord knows and is fully acquainted with the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly, those living outside God's will, shall perish, end in ruin, and come to naught. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.